हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम संजय मंगलानी फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ आर्या कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी जयपुर। दिस इज माय थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। इन लास्ट टू लेक्चर्स वी हैव कवर्ड टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ स्प्रिंग एंड वी हैव डिराइव्ड स्ट्रेस एंड डिफ्लेक्शन इक्वेशन फॉर हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल टेक अ न्यूमेरिकल ऑन हेलिकल स्प्रिंग। Before that, first we revise some formula of helical spring. First is a spring index, C is equal to capital D by D. Capital D is the mean diameter of the spring and small d is the wire diameter of the spring. Next is free length. Free length LF is equal to NTD. It is solid length of the spring, and then 15% of delta max. It is the clashing allowance. And plus delta max. Next is pitch P. Pitch P is LF, that is free length, upon NT minus 1. NT is the total number of coils. Shear stress, stress in the spring, it is equal to 8FDK upon pi d cube. Here K is the wall stress correction factor. K is 4C minus 1 upon 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 upon C, and axial deflection delta is equal to 8FDQ N upon GD. So these are the some formula of helical spring. Now this is the problem which we will discuss in this. A helical compression spring is given, which and the load is varies from 2.5 kN to 3.5 kN. Over this range of force, the deflection of the spring is 5 mm. The spring index given is 5. The spring has square and ground ends. The spring is made of cold drawn steel wire, and the maximum permissible shear stress is 525 newton per mm square. Modulus of rigidity is 81,370 newton per mm square. We have to find out the wire diameter, mean coil diameter, number of active coils, total number of coils, solid length of the spring, free length of the spring, pitch of the coil, and spring rate required and actual. So what are the given values? Here the given is force is vary from 2.5 kN to 3.5 kN. It is equal to 2500 newton to 3500 newton. Here the deflection is 5 mm. It is given for the given range of the force. It means that this deflection 5 mm is for this range. It means 3500 it is the maximum force and 2500 it is the minimum force. So the force difference of the force is 1000 newton. So this deflection delta is equal to 5 mm for 1000 newton of force. Spring index is given, C is equal to 5. Maximum permissible stress tau is given 525 newton per mm square, and G is 81,370 newton per mm square. So first we calculate the wire diameter. For wire diameter we use the formula of shear stress. We know that shear stress tau is 8FDK upon pi d cube, and K is the wall factor. We can calculate the K from this equation. C is given, so K from this equation is 1.3105. So shear stress tau is equal to 8F is here, the F is 3500. We used maximum force because this shear stress is the maximum allowable shear stress. So in this formula, we will use the maximum force, which is equal to 3500 d k pi d cube. We simplify this equation. Here this capital D by D, we can replace this capital D by D by C, and the C is 5. So from the stress equation we can find the value of wire diameter D, and it is equal to 10.546. so this is the calculated value of diameter. Now we will select the standard dimension of the wire dia from the design data handbook. So from the page number 150, here the material is cold drawn steel. So for this material these are the values, and here the range is given. So for D 10.546, the given range is 6.5 to 11, and dash 0.5. this 0.5 is basically the increment. Increment means that the value of D should be 6.5 or 7 or 7.5, 8 or 8.5, and so on. So for D, for our case D is equal to 10.546, so we can take either 10.5 or 11. So we select the larger value of D, that is equal to 11 mm. Now the coil diameter, mean coil diameter, mean coil diameter is calculated from the spring index. We know that C is equal to capital D by D, and C is 5 and small d is 11. So capital D mean diameter is 55 mm. Now number of active coils. To find the number of active coils, we use the deflection formula, and deflection is equal to 8f dq n upon gd4. Here we note that this 5 mm deflection is corresponding to 1000 newton of force. So we will take F is equal to 1000 newton. Capital D is 55, N is the number of active coil, and G shear modulus is this, and small d is 11. So from this equation we find that number of active coils is 4.475. we can take 5 coils. Now total number of coils, this point we have already discussed in the lecture first. So these are the values, and given end style of the spring is square end ground end. So for square end ground end, n is equal to nt minus 2. Here we calculate n is equal to 5, so nt is equal to n plus 2, and it is equal to 7. Now solid length, this is the solid length and this is the free length. Solid length, we know that solid length is equal to nt, that is total number of coils multiply by small d. So nt total number of coil is 7 and d is 11, so solid length is 77 mm. Sixth point is free length of the spring. We know that free length of the spring LF is equal to ntd plus 15% of delta max and delta max. Here please note that this delta max is not equal to 5 mm. 5 mm is the deflection for the 1000 newton of forces. This delta max is the maximum deflection. So delta max is the maximum deflection under the maximum load, and the maximum load is 3500. So the formula is same, delta max is 8f max dqn upon gt4, but put the value of f is 3500 newton. So from this equation we find that delta max is 19.55 mm. So LF, put this value of delta max in LF, we find that LF is equal to 99.48 mm. It can be taken as 100 mm. Now the pitch P, we know that pitch P is LF upon NT minus 1. LF is 100 and NT, total number of coil is 7. So 100 upon 6, that is equal to 16.67 mm. Now the spring rate. So given spring rate is, we know that spring rate is equal to load required per unit deflection, and in this problem the load is given 3500 maximum load and minimum load is 2500. So the difference of the load is 1000, and for that force the deflection is 5 mm. So spring rate is equal to 200 newton per mm, but actual spring rate is calculated by the formula. We know that formula of the spring rate is force per unit deflection. Put the formula of deflection, that is equal to 8f dqn upon gd4. So it comes gd4 upon 8 dqn. Substitute all the values, then we find that actual spring rate is 179 newton per mm. Now in next lecture we will take another example of different type of helical spring. Thank you.